Hello, class. Welcome to Electrical Circuits 1. This time, let's have our course introduction. We'll have many things to talk about. So we'll start with the program outcomes. By the time of graduation, we want you to apply, to have the ability to apply knowledge of mathematics and science to solve engineering problems. Mga problems na ginahatag sa inyo. Then develop and conduct appropriate experimentation, analyze and interpret data, mga laboratory experiments, mga projects, mga thesis, etc. Then design a system, component, or process to meet desired needs within realistic constraints, such as economic, environmental, social, political, ethical, health and safety, manufacturability, and sustainability in accordance with standards. So as engineers, paninghaan din ninyo na makaibalo mo design. Okay, even mamaayo og designing. Then function effectively on multidisciplinary teams and multicultural teams that establish goals, plan tasks, and meet deadlines. So mga time-bound ang inyong mga activities. Then identify, formulate, and solve complex problems in electrical engineering. Mga di gud mag-expect ka sa yun eh. Okay. Then recognize ethical and professional responsibilities in engineering practice. Communicate effectively with a range of audiences. Understand the impact of engineering solutions in a global economic, environmental, and societal context. Recognize the need for additional knowledge and engage in lifelong learning. Articulate and discuss the latest developments in the field of electrical engineering. Apply techniques, skills, and modern engineering tools necessary for electrical engineering practice. And demonstrate knowledge and understanding of engineering and management principles as a member and or leader in a team to manage projects in multidisciplinary environments, group activities. For EE101 intended learning outcome, after the completion of this course, dapat makabalo na mo analyze sa DC circuits using different techniques, katong complete response atong RLRC of RLC circuits, then get acquainted with the basics of DC circuits, that is ang atong sinusoids and phasors. For the course outline, we have we'll discuss on the basic concepts, then basic laws, methods of analysis, circuit theorems, capacitors, inductors, first and second order circuits. Then we'll also have the introduction to AC circuits, which are the sinusoids and phasors. For the grading system, exams 30%, ang midterm and final, then laboratory 30, then quiz assignment or class participation, that's 10%. Then take note of this. Para sa quiz, pwede announced, pwede po unannounced. Ito pa, pwede nga discuss ko sa topic, then after sa anang topic, mag-quiz ko. Or pwede po nga mag-quiz ko daan, ayaw ko mag-discuss sa topic. For class participation, I decided nga by group sa. So let's say, para sa inyo na section, si tungaon ako into two. Example lang ha. Then, so group A, group B. And may tabuan na si group A, mamili siya o kinsa imo solve nga member ni group B, and si group B pods mamili siya og member ni group A nga may mosolve. Then katong mga representatives nga napili, mo na imo solve dito sa board sa problem nga akong ihatag. Then ang winner, he gets ang winner, ang tanan member sa ato nga team will get 10 points, ang loser will get 0. Pero kung silang duha ang nakakorrect, then both will get 5 points. Assignment. Kini, I decided na individual siya. So para sa assignment, I will give practice problems. So for example, maghatag ko 20 problems. Dayon, kanto, inyo itong solbon. Pero isa ra inyo ang ako ang i-require nga solbon ninyo. Nga, ay such that kung maka-answer mo ana, anang isa, then 100 mo, pero kung di mo maka-answer, 0. Pero ingan niya, mahitabo. That's, ang kato isa ka problem, wala mo kay balo ko, asa atong 20. Dayon, mahitabuan na kay pwede nga i-assign na ako. For example, ikaw nga student, kini nga problem mo hang i-solve. Or pwede po nga draw lots, that is, ikaw nga student, bunot kung permeable na to kung sa ang problem mo i-solve. So, sa to pa, dapat gihapon niyo pangandaman ang 20 kaya wala mo kay balo asa inyo ang solve. Tapos ang atong student ka absent, mo ta akong tawagon. Isa sa most probably akong tawagon. So, kaya absent man siya, wala tawag na ko siya, wasay answer na pasabot, wrong siya. So, 0 yung makuha. Kung mas maayo nga, dili mo mo absent. For our laboratory, performance-based assessment rubric, na itulok ka criteria, discussion, correctness, and evaluation. Discussion 25%, correctness 25%, evaluation 50%. So ang discussion o correctness, nagbase na sa inyong lab report, evaluation, katuning sa mga questions na nako. Now for discussion, poor kung ang lab report kay lacks some parts and gives only a little explanation. So kung poor na, expect ninyong rating is from 0 to 59% lang. Pero kung ang lab report inyo kay maayo, it only lacks few illustrations and explanations. So that's good. Then rating ana will be 60 to 85%. Pero kung ang report kay detailed, then that's very good. 86 to 100% yung ma-expect ana na rating. Then kung sa correctness, kung most answers are wrong, so tapos wa pag nag-follow up, kung most answers are wrong, that's poor. Kung wala nang follow sa format, that's also poor. Pero kung nag-follow sa format tapos some answers lang ang wrong, so that's good. Pero kung nag-follow sa format tapos all answers are correct, so that's very good. Okay. So as long as not following the format, so that's poor. Evaluation. So after sa inyo hang activity, I will evaluate you to see nga nakasabot ba mo o tanan ba nakasabot. Okay. So tapos ang pagtawag na ako ana sa group member, random siya. You know, kung ano itong mangi pang tawag, kung ano ko gitawag, ang the rest, maghilom ra. No coaching dapat. Okay. So, kato siya, kung maka-answer siya, then maka-benefit ang tanan. Kung di po siya maka-answer, madamay po ng tanan. Now, kung more than two questions, kaya wala na answer, so that's poor. Kung at most two questions lang, ang wala na answer, that's good. Pero kung tanan, kaya na-answer correctly, so that's very good. Grading practices and policies. Students are able to take quizzes or exams on the set schedule and inform their teacher through email 2 days before the schedule to be given makeup exams or quizzes. Remember ha, 2 days dapat. Late submissions will not be accounted. Last time, akong gina-extend ang deadline. Ako gapang gina-accept ang late submissions. But this time, I will no longer tolerate that. So remember, late submissions will not be accounted. So kung late ka, zero na ka. Correct answers with wrong solutions are wrong. Wrong answers with correct solutions are still wrong. Then no removal exam. Ayun na. Tagam na ko. Tapos class policies. Academic dishonesty will not be tolerated. Any student found to have participated in academic dishonesty will receive a 5.0 in the course and may be subject to further disciplinary action. The State Institute's Code of Conduct prohibits students from committing the following acts of academic dishonesty: academic fraud, copying or allowing one's work to be copied, fabrication or falsification, sabotage of others' work, substitution, among others, even katong nahitabo sa removal exam. Honesty, courtesy, and respect to everyone, disregarding social position, color, gender, or culture, must be strictly upheld at all times. During class lecture, put cell phones in vibrate mode. So kung wala na naka-vibrate, tapos na initawag, so mag-disturbo ang klase, then most probably I will call you, pansiron ka na ako sa board, and kung maka-answer ka, maayo, kung dili, ma-zero ka. Number four, attendance shall be checked but not to be accounted in the grade. Okay, of course, three consecutive absences, kay madrop man ka, or ang katubang absent, ako ang tawagon. Diba? So, mo mag-check ko sa attendance. Pero, iba siya lamot sa grade. Number five, I will route a freedom paper para sa inyong comments, suggestions, corrections, questions, concerns, etc. Okay, I'm still finding unsa ang maayagin nga paagi para gid sa nga fit gid sa inyo ha sa pag-teach, etc. Ana. Or kung napa may mga questions or concerns nyo, maulaw mo, mangunta na sa klase, then you can also write that. Okay, so kanang freedom paper, you have the freedom to write adraa, then pag man sa klase ako nang basahon aron na the next meeting I can address your concerns or questions. Tapos during quiz or exam, use only pen, calculator, and food. Okay, pero ang food optional na, pero ang pen and calculator dili na optional, dapat na ginmuan na. Put other things under the chair. So, unsa man ang other things? Ang other things, kaya katong, wala na mention sa A. That is, kung dili na pen, kung dili na calculator, kung dili na pagkaon, then you should put that under your chair. C, put cell phones inside the bag. Offenders shall have a score of 0. Remember, During sa quiz o exam, dapat ang cellphone nasa sulod sa bag. So kung ang cellphone nasa sulod sa inyong bulsa, nasa sulod sa jacket, or nasa inyong desk, etc. As long as wala nasa sulod sa inyong bag, I will give you a score of 0. Turning of head to the left or to the right, talking to or asking others aside from your teacher, and sitting not in your assigned seat during the exam are offenses. Two offenses result supposedly result in a score of 0. Okay, so please take note of that. During quiz and exam, enclose only the final answer in a box. No boxed answer means no answer. Yeah, since only ang final answer man ipa-enclose, so dapat ang final answer again. So kung ang question na nga siya V2, ayaw apila o enclose si V1 o V3. F, for questions and concerns, raise your hand so your teacher can come to you and address you. For additional policies and guidelines, refer to your handbook. For academic integrity, each student in this course is expected to abide with academic integrity. Any work submitted by a student in this course for academic credit shall be the student's own work. Okay, hinumdumi, own work. Mang foul gid nang magpasol mo sa lain. Tapos, if you have any doubts about what constitutes a violation of academic integrity, just ask me. For students with disabilities, please give me the certificate, SWD or PDability certificate early. Aron nga, I can make necessary arrangements for you. Can chat me, you can PM me, or you can email me sa ilromero@cscc.edu.ph. Other matters. So how to succeed in EE 101? Study, una, study in advance. Gihataga naman mong course outline. Study in advance in class. Then study regularly and solve a lot of problems. So how do I do it? So una, sa college pa ko akong ginabuhat kay mag-study ko sa itong lecture, ang kanang discussion sa book, study ko, ako na masahon, pagkaman, matodin ko sa example problem, then akong sabton, ngano ingan ang solution. Pagkuman, ako na ang tabunan ng solution, then ako na po na mag-solve. Pagkuman ako mag-solve, ako na i-compare akong ang solution na ako, ang solution sa book. So kung magtakdo na, then maayo. Pagkuman na, dito na rin ko sa practice problem. Sa practice problem, akong buhaton, kumano, ako na solbon, kay then ako na i-compare sa answer. Kaya maghatag mo siya answer daan. Okay. So, pag gumanin na, ang katunan na yun, mapasinan din ko sa itong questions pag human sa, nasa end part sa kada chapter. So, na-review questions, na-problems, na-comprehensive problems. Diba? So, mabantayan ninyo ang ako ang types akong exam kaya na ay solving, na ay design, na po ay critical thinking. So, kung mag-prepare mo, ingan na po, supposedly, para sa akong exam ha. Solve, tapos kan designing, tapos ang kuan po, ang critical thinking, ang subton gid ang concept. Para sa designing, taraga sa book. Okay. Ang kanang sa nama mga examples si hapon. So tanta lang tawag hapon ninyo. Mga important gid yung mag-study gid mo in advance, mag-study mo regularly and mag-solve a lot of problems. Okay. Pero dili man pud noon tanan problems. Okay. Ako po, dili ang punta na akong ginasolve. Ginabuhat na ako eh. Solve ko, pag naman, natanaw ko, kini nga problem, kay lahi nga pagka-present sa problems, ako na solve one. Or kini nga problem, kay lahi yung pangayo usually. Lahi yung pangayo kaya sa mga usual na mga problems, ako na solve one. Or kini, unlaon saan ka, no? Medyo complicated niya, ako na solve one. Tapos, namdumi class niya, kung lecture, sayon gyud na ang ihatag. Okay. Pero kung quiz na, mas lisod na kaysa sa lecture. Pero kung exam na, mas lisod na kaysa sa quiz. Okay. So mo nga ingana gyud permanente basta mag-prepare mo sa quiz o sa or kung sa exam, ingana gyud permanente nga mas expected mo nga mas lisod kaysa sa gihatag sa inyo. Ha? Okay, then ay sa to pa ang karapon sa mga problems po. Kung gusto mo nga kanang maniguro sa exam, solve ninyo itong mga lisod ng mga problems. Then, class and consultation schedule. Para sa 101, gina-finalize pa yun ang inyong class lecture o laboratory ng schedule. Then, pero sa consultation mo na ni. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. Wednesday, 8:30 to 10:30 a.m. Then, during any consultation, so you can ask me, for example, sir, unsa ano siya pag-solve sa problem? Ani nga problem? So, ana nga time, I will guide you, but I will not spoon-feed you. That is, I will not solve it for you. Pero tudluan ka na ako unsa na siya pag-solve. Pero ikaw ang mo-solve. Okay? Then, activities for the week, para karon na week. Dili sa ta mo diretso sa ato ang topics sa 101 kun dili you have to watch the videos on learning how to learn. Dili sa learning how to learn, so, una, it will teach you how to learn ang unsa mo work ang ato ang brain. Kaya among ginateach sa inyo kay what to learn man. So kini na kini how to learn. Nagtuo ko nga makatabang gid para sa inyo. Then number two, you have to make a study plan para sa 101. Number three, you have to make a study schedule. Maghimo ra ko o Google Classroom na to. Tapos dito ninyo i-submit si items 2 o 3. Okay, para sa study plan, for example, yung mga study plan kay kada buntag mag-study ka in advance para sa lesson anang adlaw. Mag-inurang, mag-scan ka na. Tapos, pag human na po daan na after sa inyohang klase sa particular nga sa E101 inyo na po imuha na pong i-scan balik ang imuhang notes then pagkagabi na po before ka matulog i-scan mo balik ang imuhang notes so bali mo na imong study plan now, para sa study schedule pwede nga every 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. mo na ako ang time nga mag-study ko in advance ano okay so every day. So let's say nga na yung study schedule. Yeah, every seven, before matulog, ana, let's say 8 to 9 to 9:30, ana, ako na pong i-scan balik ako ang notes. Okay? So make a study plan and make a study schedule. Remember class, excellence is not being the best. Excellence is doing your best. Thank you.